Welcome to Woosh TV. In this video we will talk about the you will never be rich if you keep doing these 10 things. So before starting this video, like this video and subscribe to Woosh TV for future updates. There are no secrets to becoming wealthy overnight, but there are several tried and true methods that can assist you. The truth is that everyone has the same chance of becoming wealthy. Some people may confront more difficulties than others. However, everyone has the option to take use of it. Have you ever pondered why some people seem to be wealthy while others don't? It's mostly due to their way of life and thinking. I've compiled a list of 10 symptoms that you'll never be wealthy, ranging from living beyond your means to having a single source of income. Number 10. Have a full-time job and work. There is no such thing as absolute truth in our world. Everyone has the ability to shape their destiny as they choose, and the only constraint is the individual's own head. But, in my brief life and based on a few books I've read, I've determined that most prosperous millionaires share one trait: they are all unemployed. The following are some of the reasons. On average, an entrepreneur spends much more time researching and arranging their investments. Entrepreneurs are rarely complacent about their financial status. They are constantly on the watch for negative changes, which motivates them to devote time and effort to safeguarding their assets. They must take responsibility for their own financial condition because no one else would. As an entrepreneur, you must accept greater duties and dangers. Get out of their comfort zone and find new ways to make money. Number 9. Put too much emphasis on saving. If you deposit $1,000 in a bank account that earns 1% yearly interest in January, you will currently have $10 in your account. If, on the other hand, you had purchased 3 shares of Netflix for $324 in January 2020, you would currently have $580 in your pocket. I'm not suggesting that you put all of your money into equities. That requires research and knowledge of the market. This means that there are better uses for your money than putting it in a savings account. Monthly deposits into a bank account will not make you wealthy. Make prudent investments and leverage your funds to generate new sources of income. There are several, and even risk-free, ways to put your savings to work today in order to create more income tomorrow. Purchasing courses, for example, is one of the expenditures I am currently making. One of the best ways to invest your money is in knowledge. Number 8. Believe in easy money. Many companies claim to provide you with financial freedom. Many people still believe that if they work with them, they will get wealthy, but they do not actually strive to make you wealthy. Some of them, according to David O'Leary, are gambling. The system in gambling causes people to lose money. Also, to make someone feel fortunate. In the long run, gamblers lose far more than they win. No product network marketing is a type of network marketing that does not require the sale of a product. Without a product, network marketing will inevitably devolve into a Ponzi scam. If you are fortunate enough to be one of the first to enter, you will make a lot of money quickly, but the business will eventually become unsustainable, and if you have any money or friends with you at the time, you will lose everything. Loaning money on the side, family members will be unconcerned about your service. You will not put your family in jail if they refuse to pay you. No matter how professional and lawful you want to be when doing business with a family member, it will always appear informal. Number 7. Never learn anything about money. You will never be able to receive a driver's license if you do not learn how to drive properly. Riding in a vehicle with someone who does not understand basic regulations is dangerous. The same may be said of money. You will never be able to make money work for you if you do not understand how money works. I know people who have no idea how taxes operate or why their employers withhold specific portions of their pay. I'm always curious as to how they know they aren't being conned if they don't care what the corporations do with their money. People with financial knowledge are better able to comprehend their options, make informed decisions, understand where to seek assistance, and take action to settle disputes. In my nation, for example, there is a rule that states that people who earn a specific amount of money while studying would receive a 10% annual refund from the government of the taxes they spend on school. Anyway, out of the 200 people that studied with me, I believe I only know 3 people who use that benefit. Number 6. Don't have goals for your money. Goals enabled me to purchase my first automobile at the age of 19, my first home at the age of 22, and travel twice a year every year. Every year, I create an Excel budget and determine what I want to accomplish with the funds. that helps me to work harder and spend less money on things that aren't necessary to achieve my goals. Having a financial goal is the most effective approach to save and grow your income. If you don't know what you want to do with your money, saving it isn't reasonable, it's pointless. Do you wish to purchase a home? Those are legitimate objectives that you can set in order to save money. The majority of people who do not have a savings goal do not have a single dollar in their account. They go from day to day, savoring the present. You can't start working toward your financial goals if you don't know what they are. Number 5, you haven't started investing. Investing is an important part of excellent money management since it offers financial security in the present and the future. You not only have more money in the bank, but you also have another source of income. The only way to acquire both growing wealth and passive income is to invest. If you do not invest your money, you are indicating that you intend to live only on your monthly pay and do not intend to retire until the age of 65. Investing is the way to go if you want to retire early or become financially independent. Any investment is preferable to none, but you must choose wisely. Number 4, have only one source of income. It's a show of conformity to live solely on your employment salary. You have no objectives or aims for growth if you are not looking for new sources of revenue. Although your job provides you with financial security and helps you to live a peaceful life, having multiple sources of income allows you to attain financial freedom in the long run. On average, millionaires have 7 sources of income. They've discovered that the key to long-term wealth building is diversification and the creation of many streams of income. This is the key to gaining financial independence, which many people desire. Having many sources of income offers numerous advantages, the most important of which is security. If the last decade has taught us anything, it's that no job is safe. The economy fluctuates wildly beyond anyone's control, and for most people, their day job is their only source of income. They find themselves in considerable financial problems when that steady 9-to-5 disappears. Number 3, don't step out of your comfort zone. To become wealthy, you must take risks and overcome your fears. Exploring new thoughts and ideas and adopting them into our life necessitates stepping outside of our usual comfort zone. The more at ease you are in your small cocoon, the less risks you will take, and the fewer opportunities that will present themselves to you. The more fearful you get, the less people you will meet and the fewer new tactics you will experiment with. You stop growing the moment you get comfy. Number 2. Do you believe that being wealthy is only for the fortunate? There is no such thing as divine luck or chance in this life. Everything that occurs in our lives is a product of our actions. Getting money can be a difficult task. If you believe that becoming wealthy is a result of chance, you are unwilling to work hard or take risks in order to succeed. People get affluent as a result of tens of thousands of strategic decisions and acts. They build skills, produce goods, provide services, and, most importantly, add value to others. It's normal to look at someone who is wealthy and attribute their success to some fortunate circumstance. It's difficult to know all of the thousands of decisions and activities that go into making a successful business. Number 1. Get a credit card and spend a lot. Every month, blowing your entire wage, and then some, is not a prescription for financial success. Neither is emptying your savings account or racking up credit card debt. The majority of people who spend more than they make will never be financially healthy. Fill out your credit card and pay only the minimum. Buy automobiles that are more expensive than your ability, and never make extra payments on your loan if you want to be poor for the rest of your life. But keep in mind that being wealthy on social media isn't the same as being wealthy in real life. Trying to impress people who don't care about you isn't going to help you live a happy life. To cut back on spending, start by keeping track of where your money goes each month. Try to focus on places where you can make cuts that aren't absolutely necessary. Then make a realistic budget to guarantee you have enough money to pay your expenses and invest. What do you think about this video? Do let us know down in the comments section below. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from us again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go.